various tools required during installation: heat gun, cutter, scrapping tool, vinyl tapes, ratchet spanner, screwdriver, plug, measuring tape, and markers. Note: before you start, please ensure the workplace is suitable for the jointer to install the termination kit. Let us now look at the correct procedure of installing termination kits. Step 1. Positioning of the cable. Lay the cable in the correct position, ensuring it is stable and has adequate clearance from the ground to allow for easy installation. Step 2. Measuring the installation points. Identify the working section of the cable where the termination will be installed. Measure the anti-tracking tube according to the manufacturer's specifications and mark the initial length, 0.1. Add an extra 50 plus minus 10 millimeters, 0.2, for future adjustments, followed by another 200 plus minus 10 millimeters marking, 0.3, for the final termination step. Step 3. Insulation cutting. Place the metal spring coil at 0.1. Using the appropriate tool, cut and strip the topmost insulation layer of the cable. Step 4. Cutting the armor. Expose and cut the armor layer of the cable. Step 5. Cutting the inner PVC insulation. Measure 20 to 50 millimeters, 0.1 from the metal constant for spring. This length may vary between manufacturers. Now, temporarily remove the spring. Then, reposition the spring to 0.1 and you can strip off the inner PVC insulation layer between 0.1 and 0.0. Step 6. Preparing the inner core. Remove the excess PVC fillers between 0.0 and 1-. Ensure the fillers don't remain inside the cable. Carefully unwrap the four spring coil and secure the copper screen with vinyl adhesive tape to prevent it from separating from the cable core. Step 7. Exposing the armor for earthing. Reposition the metal force spring coil at 0.2. Now, cut the outermost insulative layer of this section to expose the armor for earthing. Step 8. Screen earthing process. Connect the braided earth cable to the cable screen. For three core cables, use a triangular spacer. Wrap the earth cable around the core one time, securing it with a force spring coil and vinyl adhesive tape. Step 9. Armor earthing. Attach another earthing cable to the exposed armor between 0.1 and 2. Secure it with a four spring coil and vinyl adhesive tape. Step 10. Mastic wrapping over earthing terminal. Wrap filling mastic tape from the exposed armor to the cable screen, followed by sealing mastic tape to ensure no moisture or dust ingress. Also, apply grease over the wrapped section. Step 11. Breakout fitting. Slide the breakout over the Mastic wrapped section and fit it securely. Heat shrink it using a flame gun, ensuring even heat distribution. Avoid direct flame contact to prevent the polymer from burning or charring. Step 12. Preparing for stress controlled tubing installation. Measure and mark a 30 to 60 millimeters gap between the breakout tip and the copper screen. Use vinyl tape to mark the position. Now strip the copper screen up to the marked point, exposing the semi-black conducting layer. Step 13. Scraping the semi-conducting layer. Mark 20 to 40 millimeters above the vinyl adhesive tape, as per the manufacturer's specifications. Carefully remove the semiconducting layer using a scraping tool so that the underlying layer remains undamaged. As per the lug supplied by the manufacturer, cut the tip of the XLPE insulation to expose the bare aluminium or copper conductor which will go inside the lug for termination. Step 14. Preparing the surface for final tubing installation. Smooth out the insulative layer using manufacturer provided sandpaper. Then clean the surface with a cotton cloth and cleaning solvent to remove excess dust and debris. Step 15. Installing the stress control tube. Apply yellow stress relief Mastic to the joints, first between the screen and the semiconducting layer, then between the insulation and semiconducting layer. Apply grease to the insulative part and slide the stress control tube into position. Heat shrink the tube evenly and wrap yellow Mastic tape over both ends of the shrunk stress control tube. Step 16. Installing the anti-tracking tube. Insert the anti-tracking tube to cover the cable length from the breakout to the exposed conductor. Now heat shrink the tube using the appropriate precautions. Step 17. Inserting the rain shed. Slide the bottom and top rain sheds in the core. Please note that rain sheds are not used for 11 kV indoor termination kits. Step 18. Connecting lugs. Insert the exposed bare conductor to the lug barrel. Use a ratchet to tighten the shear head lugs until the head breaks, or use a crimping tool to apply the manufacturer supplied torque for crimping lugs. Step 19. Sealing the lug connection. Wrap filling Mastic, followed by sealing Mastic tape around the bottom of the lug and the anti-tracking tube to prevent moisture ingress. Slide the lug sealing tube halfway over both the lug and anti-tracking tube and heat shrink it evenly. Step 20. Final rain shed positioning and shrinking. Ensure the rain sheds are properly positioned before heat shrinking them. Apply heat evenly to avoid burning. Step 21. Applying phase color rings. Place the phase color rings according to the original phase color sequence and heat them to secure them in place. This concludes the installation process for a medium voltage, high shrinkable 3-core termination kit. At Axis, we have a team of over 50 engineers available to assist with designing, installing and testing heat shrink materials. Our components are trusted and installed in a variety of settings worldwide, including data centers, factories and residential and commercial buildings.